yesterday, Forrest Whitaker received a Best Actor Oscar nomination for his brilliant portrayal of brutal dictator Idi Amin in The Last King of Scotland. We were talking about it. He is so great.
Brilliant.
We want you to take a look.
I can't think. I can't sleep. Look at this. Look at this. The British newspapers say I am a madman. The American newspapers say I am a cannibal. I am a cannibal, huh? Huh? These are lies! I should throw them out for good. Only you can impress from now on.
Wow. Does that give you a taste? Listen, I just said, if he doesn't win the Oscar, I'm gonna pick it.
All right.
Please welcome Forrest Whitaker.
To be here.
Unbelievable, sir.
I don't want to do you harm by saying that because all the other nominees are terrific, okay? So
yeah,
I shouldn't
sure.
say, however, just thinking of me. Okay. So when you won the Golden Globe, you gave the most emotional, you know, tears in your eyes. Did you just not expect it?
I mean, no, I lived in the moment. Until I heard my name, I didn't know if it was going to be true.
Really?
And when I heard it, I was overwhelmed, really. I started stuttering around and stuff. I wish I was more coherent, but...
No, it was very beautiful. It really was. Very authentic and touching.
Helen Mirren has said, I was reading it today, that to have the Oscar, I mean, that's it. That's the biggest, you know, thing an actor can get. Do you feel that way?
The biggest thing, I mean, it's historic. I mean, it goes down in history, and forever, people will always know that moment, you know? I mean, I think the private moments, the sort of individual moments when you're working and stuff, and you do something and it's pure magic, that's what I kind of live for more, where you just, when you're enveloped by, like, some sort of...
You're not going to cry at the Academy Award?
Who knows? Maybe.
I don't know. I mean, if I were to win, I am sure I'll be thrown.
This was one of the most, I mean, brutal dictators in Africa. I mean, and what was the most shocking thing that you learned in studying and just learning to play this role? Because you were brilliant. I just can't imagine the things you had to figure out and learn during the process.
I guess I was really thrown off that when I was in Uganda, that the Ugandans have a different point of view on Idi Amin than the people in the West.
No yes. kidding. Yeah. What's their point of view?
You know, there's many people who, like, think of him as a hero.
No kidding.
Yeah, and then there's some who, like, live in between, like, look at the atrocities, but then they feel like he freed them from some oppression, you know?
I think every dictatorship has, the people in the country feel that way very often, because some people do benefit from a dictatorship, and those are the ones. But did the Ugandans, I was reading, they actually believed you were Amin, some of them. True?
Well, you know, he's such a legend, and he only died a few years ago.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And in the outskirts, you know, where when you're saying a speech and you're having a political rally, and people are coming, and they don't really know. Mm-hmm. They think maybe he's come back, maybe he's here. They don't know him. The younger kids don't know
right,
him.
Right, right. Yeah.
So,
is it true that you stayed in character throughout the filming of this movie? Because I imagine that would be very draining. I mean, because he was in a way such a charismatic and dark character.
It was kind of invigorating, that, and I kept the accent. You
the
know?
Accent,
yeah,
accent.
Which was fantastic for us. Unbelievable.
Thanks.
Really, you believed you were him.
I felt like I was trying to get the spirit of the guy, and I felt like the accent and Kiswahili were the keys into who he was, the way he thought, the way.
Also, he had a sort of a sense of humor. He laughed
he had charisma.
A lot,
mm-hmm.
yeah. and he. So I presume that you kept that going too, because you were able so fluidly to go back and forth, the terrorist to the sort of guy who was having fun.
Yeah, I mean, that was the thing when I looked at all the tapes and studied him so much. People loved him because he had such a good sense of humor. He was very much a party person.
Well, he starts off lovable in the film.
And then it goes to the...
But what about the cannibalism? Did he actually eat people or not? You couldn't tell exactly
well,
from the movie.
Well, you didn't.
I know. No, he didn't do that. But did Idi Amin do it? Did Idi Gourmet do it?
I couldn't find anybody who said that was true. And I talked to everybody. I talked to his brothers and sisters, his girlfriends, I mean, ministers, generals. I never found anybody to confirm that.
This is such a role, and we have all seen it, and we're all stunned by it. If you haven't seen it, do so. But you've done many, many films, but this is huge for you. But I'd heard that you said that you didn't think a few years ago that you would be worthy of this kind of attention. After all that, you direct and act and so many things. Did you feel that way?
Well, I mean, I think it's hard sometimes to live in the moment and, like, accept and realize that that it's for you.
Mm. Yeah.
You know, and I think at an earlier time in my life, I wouldn't have been able to. I was kind of a hermit. I was more insular, and I wouldn't have been able to celebrate.
Yeah.
And now I've learned how to celebrate.
That's
I celebrate
nice.
Moments and celebrate life in a bigger way. Mm. And so I think it's a perfect time for this to be happening.
That's
for
beautiful.
Me.
Are your children, did your children see it? I know you have a young one, but the teenagers, were they, and your wife, how did she respond to watching the film?
She really loved it.
Yes.
I mean, she thought it was amazing. I mean, my son was like blown away.
Yeah.
I couldn't show the little ones. They haven't really seen many of my movies because they're all
it's
mostly
a little scary,
hard.
Certain parts.
Yes.
Yeah. Do you
it's
consult
brutal.
Them when you're thinking about taking certain roles? Do they play a role in your role?
I talk to them about what I'm about to do and ask them what they think, and sometimes like work on my littlest one will like try to read the lines
How
with me
old
or
is
something.
Littlest one?
She's 8. Yeah, the oldest is 16.
Do you find now, I mean, after this enormous role, are other parts coming in?
I think people are talking to me about a lot of movies right now.
They are.
But he works always.
I know.
Yeah. The man has never stopped
working. But this is so big.
Yes.
You know, I just wonder, are you getting other big starring roles? I hope so.
Would be great. I mean, I want to just keep working with good directors and good people. I've been lucky.
Who directed Brit in The Crying Game? People think you were British. I thought you might have been British this morning. I said, is he American?
Oh, cool.
Yeah, because you're so versatile. So you'll always work.
Who directed this film for us?
Kevin MacDonald. He's a Scottish director.
Beautifully,
he's really talented.
Beautifully done.
Yeah. This is his first movie.
It is.
Mm-hmm.
Is
wow.
It really?
Yeah, he's done documentaries yeah. before, but it's his first film.
Okay. Yeah, well, mm-hmm. it's absolutely magnificent work, and you're a charming, charming man. I hope that you win because you deserve it. I had nightmares all night from this movie, and in the best way that it got into my soul. So thank you for that because it really it moved me very much.
Yes. Thank you.
And you're a brilliant actor. Go see it. The Last King of Scotland is in theaters now. We'll be back in the, right after this break with some cookies, I think.